How you doing there? Dragon Man here, and this is my day off, and of course I'm always working. This is my oldies but goodies room. It's 15,000 square feet. It's full of around 34 hot rods, and we're taking most of them out today. The reason is I'm going to put these LED bulbs in. See this package of bulbs? LED bulbs. Very expensive. 10 in a box, $90. And I need like 15 boxes. But what are you going to do? So this way the whole oldies and goodies room be a lot brighter and people can see more stuff. So for the next 3 or 4 hours, we'll be starting up hot rods and lining them up in front of my store. And we're going to make a video. And then my helpers are going to gas them all up. And then we put them away. It's good to use all of them, you know, every couple of months. Okay, hope you enjoy the video. That's my 31 Vicky. Happens to be a very rare car. They only made these for a few years. And pretty soon, this is gonna look like hot rod heaven. Okay, follow me, let's get another one. Ford, all metal. This is the oldest hot rod I have. Just got it the other day. See, most T-buckets are fiberglass, and they don't have doors. All metal. That body is over 100 years old. Okay, let's grab another one. They all ran like that. That's got a 383 stroker motor in it. 5-speed standard transmission.
Yeah.
411 gears in the rear.
That's one of my favorites.
Yeah, I love that 55. Okay, let's grab another one. Let me show you guys what we're doing here. This is what we do. When I take all the cars out, we check the trannies, we check the antifreeze, and we gas them all up. And I always use stable. See? Fuel stabilizer. This is really good. It lasts about 3 years, and it's very good if you're gonna put your car away for the winter and it's gonna sit for about 5 or 6 months. This way the carburetor won't get shellacked, you know, with the old gas, and it keeps everything nice and fresh. So we use a lot of this. So we mix, I mix half a can of this in every 5 gallons. It's a lot more than what they recommend, but more is better than not enough. Beautiful car. Yeah, this is a 1955 Ford. It's got hydraulics built into it, Continental kit, skirts, white wall tires. It's got a 302 V8 motor, Ford motor, and a lot of work went into this car. Beautiful. This really brings you back into the 50s. Okay, give me a ride back. here's one of my 32 three windows. It's got a 454 Chevy motor in it, turbo 400 transmission, and Ford 9-inch rear. Really built good. A lot of fun to drive. Okay, let me get the pickup here and we'll go back and get another one. I'm going to take out my 56 Chevy is next. Coming up. You guys having fun yet? Well, I am. '56 Chevy. This is a really, really perfect car. Looks like it was made yesterday. It's got a 350 small block Chevy motor in it, 4-speed on the floor, Munson transmission, and a Chevy rear end, 411 gears. So now I have I got a 55, a 56, 57, 58, and 59 Chevy. What a collection. Okay, I'm gonna bring out, let's see, my 29 sedan. That's next. Stand by, folks. Beautiful car, drives just like a brand new one. Got a 350 motor in it, automatic transmission, 9-inch Ford rear, and air conditioning. It's got disc brakes in the front. Yeah, a lot of work went into building this one, and it was built right. It's got a box chassis. I have pictures of this car being built from scratch, even when it was stock. Took the guy about 3 years to get it in this condition. Okay, let me get my ride over here. Pull it up. See, I'm bringing out, let's see, I'm bringing out a 57 Chevy next. Stand by. This is my 56 Ford Victoria, and if you could go around it with the camera, this is like immaculate. 1956 Victoria, pretty rare car. It's got a Thunderbird motor in it. Beautiful shape. Okay, we're gonna get another one. Get the compressor?
Yeah, you wanna grab the batteries?
Oh yeah, yeah. Yeah, bring the truck over here. Gotta take some batteries out. Oh, we're having a great day. Beautiful day in Colorado Springs. Supposed to be 75 degrees. It's springtime. Best place to live in the United States. Guaranteed. Oh, that was fun. 1926 Ford Coupe, 383 stroke motor. This is a beautiful car. A lot of work went into this. Look at that paint job. See, it's got dragons on the door. Got a narrowed Ford rear, 16-inch wide Mickey Thompson tires on the back, disc brakes in the front, automatic transmission, and this is in excellent shape, like most of my other ones. Okay, let me go in the oldies room and see if that 57 start up. Chevy, 350 small block Chevy motor, four on the floor, Munson transmission, Chevy rear end, excellent shape. Just like the kids used to take to school in the 60s. Brings back a lot of memories. I gotta pull the battery out so we could put it in another vehicle. This is the most fun you can have on a day off. What's more fun than this? And then I'll probably take a couple of them cruising, you know, through town. Beautiful day. Okay, gotta get another vehicle. Okay guys, chopped and channeled. That means the top's been sectioned, probably about 3 inches, and the whole body's been channeled, lowered over the chassis. That's what chopped and channeled means. This is a 1929 Ford, and the way you tell the difference, see, the 29s, see they have an indentation here on the cowl. And then in 1930-31, they did away with that, so there's more foot room, you know, inside the vehicle. But yeah, these are a lot of fun to drive. I gotta watch what I eat. Another year or so, I won't fit in here. Okay, where's my ride? Yup, taxi! Boy, that thing's got a lot of power. I like feeling the power, watching the wheel spin. A lot of fun. Yeah, this one here's a tea bucket, like a 1923, and it's got a fiberglass body on it. 383 stroke motor. The motor is way too big for this type of vehicle. It's a lot of fun to drive. Okay, let's bring it up. let's see. I think I'm going to take out my 1958. It'll be next. 1958 Chevy Impala. How you doing, guys? This is my tow truck, if you've never seen it. It's got a late model 350 small block Chevy motor in it. And it's really in excellent shape, like all my other stuff. And with this many cars, you gotta have a tow truck. So this is my tow truck. Okay, next we're gonna get out my 58 Chevy. We're getting it running right now. Stand by. Don't change the station. Chevy, 350 motor in it. Let's see. Yeah, it's really a 50 style. The paint job on here, these are called scallops. That was real popular in the 50s and 60s. And see, it's got dumpers. These are called dumpers. You know, if you're gonna race somebody, you take the three bolts out and it eliminates the, bypasses the muffler. Gives the motor more power. See, it's got shaved door handles. So on the keychain, there's a little push button and hits the solenoid and the door opens. And this is really in excellent shape. Runs perfect, like all my others. Okay, let me go grab another one. That's it. Cool, another tea bucket, and you can always tell the metal body ones. See, they have a door on the right side, just the way they came from the factory. This is really, really nice. That's why I bought it. This is one of the nicest tea buckets I ever seen. Yeah, check it out. A lot of work went into this. A lot of fun to drive. They really don't weigh that much. Okay. Go get another one. Pretty cool. This is my 49 Ford. It's got a flathead motor in it and three deuces, white wall tires. Really a lot of fun to drive. It's got the leather, white and red leather rolling pleated interior. This is really a 50 style. 1949 Ford. Okay guys, let me grab another one. This is a 1928 Roadster. This is a real hot rod. This was built in the early 60s. by a guy in Colorado, and he passed away. I ended up buying it from his family. I converted everything to 12 volt, it used to be 6 volt. And it had a Strongbird 97 two barrel carburetor on it, and I put a four barrel on there. You know, gotta update everything. But this is really, really neat, because back then in the early 60s, you couldn't really buy hot rod parts. You know, you really had to make everything. And that's what this fella did. Did a great job. Okay guys, well that's about all I'm taking out today. The weather's starting to change, and I want to drive a few of these around, and we still have to gas them all up. So you guys have a great day, and thanks a lot for watching.